TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 30th of August. Construction work on India-Pakistan cross-border pilgrim corridor resumes. Sikh girl abducted, forcibly converted to Islam in Pakistan. And locals highlight corruption in developmental works in Gilgit-Baltistan. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said that the government has set a target of setting up 12,500 Ayush centres across India. Ayush stands for Ayurveda, Yoga and Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday said the government has set a target of setting up 12,500 Ayurveda, Yoga and Naturopathy, Yunani, Siddha and Homeopathy or Ayush centers across India, 4,000 of which will be set up this year. The main focus of these centers will be empowering the community for self-care by imbibing Ayush-based healthy food and lifestyle, social behavior and use of medicinal plants for primary health care. Speaking at Yoga Awards ceremony in capital New Delhi, Modi said that government was working towards bringing in more professionals in the field of Ayush and necessary steps are being taken to that effect.
Desh bhar mein 12,500 Ayush center banane ka bhi lakshya hai. Jisme se aaj 10 Ayush health and wellness centers ka udghatan जो कि हरियाणा के लिए किया गया और वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस से करने का मुझे मौका मिला और वहां भी बहुत बड़ी तादाद में हरियाणा के उत्साही लोग मुझे नजर आ रहे हैं।
Prime Minister Modi said Ayush and Yoga are strong pillars of Fit India movement. The nationwide Fit India movement was launched by Modi on Thursday, aimed at encouraging people to inculcate physical activity and sports in their day-to-day life.
A technical meeting between the delegations of India and Pakistan was held on Friday at the zero point of under construction Kartarpur cross-border pilgrim corridor. The work on the corridor, which had got halted for a while, has resumed. Upon completion, the corridor will enable Indian Sikh pilgrims to visit their holy places of worship in Pakistan.
The work on the cross-border Sikh pilgrim route Kartarpur corridor, which got halted for a while, has resumed. Workers were seen laying asphalt on the road that will connect Dera Baba Nanak Shrine in India to Gurdwara Kartarpur Sahib in Pakistan on Thursday. The corridor will enable visa-free travel for Indian Sikh pilgrims to visit the Kartarpur Sahib Shrine associated with Guru Nanak, the founder of Sikhism. Officials said the work will be completed on time before the inauguration of the corridor on the occasion of 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak in November.
ਇਹ ਕਰਤਾਰਪੁਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਕੋਰੀਡੋਰ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਜੋ ਆਪਾਂ ਰਸਤੇ ਦਾ ਲੰਘੇ ਦਾ ਕੰਮ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕੀਤਾ ਸੀ ਅੱਜ ਤੋਂ ਕੁਝ ਸਮੇਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਕੰਪਲੀਟ ਕਰਨ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਹੁਣ ਅੱਜ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਹ DPM ਯਾਨੀ ਕਿ ਲੁੱਕ ਪਾਉਣ ਦਾ ਕੰਮ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਹੈ।
ਇੰਡੀਆ ਐਂਡ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਹੈਵ ਹੈਲਡ ਟੈਕਨੀਕਲ ਲੈਵਲ ਟਾਕਸ ਔਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਰੀਡੋਰ ਡਿਸਪਾਈਟ ਸੋਰਿੰਗ ਟੈਂਸ਼ਨਸ। ਬੋਥ ਸਾਈਡਸ ਹੈਡ ਅਰਲੀਅਰ ਐਗਰੀਡ ਟੂ ਅ ਮੈਜੋਰਿਟੀ ਆਫ ਮੋਡੈਲਿਟੀਜ਼ ਫਾਰ ਦਾ ਸਮੂਥ ਪੈਸੇਜ ਆਫ ਦਾ ਪਿਲਗ੍ਰਿਮਸ। ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ ਵਿਚ ਅਨਾਊਂਸਡ ਟੂ ਡਾਊਨਗ੍ਰੇਡ ਡਿਪਲੋਮੈਟਿਕ ਟਾਈਜ਼ ਵਿਦ ਇੰਡੀਆ over New Delhi's move to change special status granted to Jammu and Kashmir earlier this month, has also said that the work on the corridor will continue as planned.
In news from Pakistan, a 19-year-old Sikh girl has been allegedly abducted, forcefully converted and married to a Muslim boy at gunpoint in Pakistan's Nankana Sahib city. The horrific incident has been condemned in neighbouring India.
A Sikh girl has been allegedly abducted and forcefully converted to Islam in Pakistan's Nankana Sahib city. Family of 19-year-old Jagjeet Kaur, whose father is a Granthi or priest, has alleged that she was forced to marry a Muslim boy and converted to Islam at gunpoint. A video of Jagjeet Kaur at the wedding ceremony has also gone viral on social media, where she was converted to Islam and named Aisha. The horrific incident is also being condemned in neighboring India.
कल रात को हमारे परिवार के साथ एक बहुत दर्दनाक वाकया हुआ है। कुछ गुंडे रात को हमारे घर पे आए, उन्होंने हमारी छोटी बहन को घसीट के ले गए और उनको जबरदस्ती टॉर्चर करके इस्लाम कबूल करवाया।
इतनी गिरी हुई हरकत की एक तरफ जहां आतंकवाद को पना दी उससे तो बदनाम हुए थे, अब माइनॉरिटीज के ऊपर, जहां पहले हिंदू लड़कियों के ऊपर और अब सिखों के, अब एक गुरुद्वारा साहब से लड़की को आप उठा के जबरन उसको धर्म बदलने के लिए मजबूर करके उसका निकाह किया जाए, इससे और गिरी हुई हरकत क्या हो सकती है।
Human rights activists accuse that several girls from minority communities have been abducted, forcibly converted to Islam and married to Muslim men in Pakistan in the past few years. Earlier this year, in a similar incident, two Hindu minor sisters were reportedly kidnapped, and later a video of their conversion and solemnization of their marriage had surfaced in social media.
Moving on. Locals have highlighted corruption in developmental works in the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan. They blame the nexus of the administration and the contractors responsible for the current situation, where projects are deliberately delayed to earn more money.
Gilgit-Baltistan is home to some of the most captivating natural sceneries on earth, and its serene landscape has the potential of making it a tourist hotspot. However, roads and other infrastructure in the illegally occupied region are in shambles. Potholes are widespread on the roads that are dug in the name of sewage treatment work. Locals have blamed the nexus of the administration and the contractors responsible for the current situation. They have accused that to make more money, contractors deliberately delay the time frame of projects given to them.
बहुत शुक्रिया कि आप यहाँ पे आ गए। आप देख रहे हैं कि तीन हफ्तों से ये काम चल रहा है, ये नाले की सफाई के नाम से अरबों रुपए की, करोड़ों रुपए की करप्शन यहाँ पे ये लोग कर रहे हैं। सूबाई गवर्नमेंट, जिसका सीएम का जो साला है यहाँ पे इस ठेके के अंदर पार्टनर बना हुआ है, और ये डेढ़ साल पहले बनाया गया था, इसको सेवरेज के नाम दे के बनाया गया था। हर साल बाद पैसे कमाने का एक जरिया बनाया इन लोगों ने, ठीक चीज़ को भी ये लोग खराब कर लेते हैं कि ताकि नए करप्शन करने के लिए इनके लिए आसानी पैदा हो।
उसके अलावा लोग बड़ी तकलीफ में है सर इससे, और गवर्नमेंट इससे कोई मतलब एक्शन नहीं ले रही है, और अपने करीब तरीन रिश्तेदारों को ठेके दे के सही सलामत चीज़ भी ख़राब कर रहे हैं ये लोग। और जहाँ पे काम करने की जगह है वहाँ पे काम होता नहीं है, जहाँ पे काम न करने किसी काम की ज़रूरत नहीं है वहाँ पे आके खुदाई कर लेते।
The common public blames that they are reeling under a life of misery in Gilgit-Baltistan, which Pakistan illegally occupied more than 7 decades ago. Pakistan's apathy is also visible in the fact that the region doesn't find a space in any government framework and is largely treated as a colony.
US President Donald Trump has said that the US plans to withdraw more than 5,000 American troops from Afghanistan and then will determine further drawdowns in the longest war in American history.
U.S. President Donald Trump on Thursday said that he intends to pull thousands of U.S. troops out of Afghanistan, but would maintain a presence of 8,600 for now. Trump, while speaking to Fox News Radio, also confirmed that negotiators are working on a U.S. troop drawdown in Afghanistan, but offered assurances that the U.S. will keep a presence in the country. His comments come as U.S. envoy Zalmay Khalilzad is in his 9th round of talks with the Taliban to find a resolution to the nearly 18-year-old war in Afghanistan. The peace talks is based on which U.S. forces would withdraw from Afghanistan in exchange for assurances by the Taliban insurgents that Afghanistan would not become a peace haven for other terrorist groups. Earlier on Wednesday, General Joseph Dunford, chairman of the Joint Chief of Staff, said that it was too early to talk about a full American troop withdrawal from Afghanistan. He said that any U.S. deal with the Taliban would be based on security conditions on the ground and that Afghan forces weren't yet able to secure the country without help from allied forces.
The Archbishop of Canterbury, Justin Welby, on Thursday visited a church which was bombed during the Easter Sunday attacks in Sri Lanka, which killed more than 250 people. Welby was also scheduled to meet several political and religious leaders in Sri Lanka during his three-day visit.
Justin Welby, the Archbishop of Canterbury, on Thursday visited one of the churches bombed during the Easter Sunday attacks in Sri Lanka during his three-day visit to the country. Welby offered flowers at a memorial commemorating more than 250 victims killed in the attacks. He also gave gifts to the injured children inside the recently restored St. Sebastian's Church. During his visit to Sri Lanka, Welby was expected to meet top Sri Lankan politician leadership, including the President and the Prime Minister. He was also scheduled to meet with religious leaders and the Anglican community.
I know that by your courage, your faith and your love, I see the true Christ.
The Easter Sunday bombings on April 21st were claimed by Islamic militants who targeted churches and luxury hotels in the country. The attacks shattered a decade of relative peace after the end of a 25-year-long civil war in Sri Lanka.
The 41st edition of a cultural festival in India's eastern Odisha province attracted scores of music and dance lovers. The three-day event, which concluded on Thursday, witnessed performances depicting different moods of monsoon season.
A three-day cultural festival in Bhubaneswar city of India's eastern Odisha province attracted scores of music and dance lovers. The theme of the 41st edition of the Barsha or Rain Festival, which concluded on Thursday, was dance and music related to the monsoon season. The event witnessed eminent artists as well as promising young talents from the province performing ancient Indian classical dance Odissi.
ये बरसा फेस्टिवल जो है 41वां बरसा फेस्टिवल इस साल हो रहा है आज ख़त्म हुआ और ये पहले पाँच दिन तक होता था और यहाँ पर बरसा के ऊपर ढेर सारे कार्यक्रम हुआ है संगीत नृत्य और मैजिक शो भी हुआ है
The performances were a visual treat for audiences who had come from across India to attend the festival. Organized by Chinta Uchetna, a socio-cultural association, the annual event aims to promote dance and music of Odisha province at the national and international level.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Construction work on India-Pakistan cross-border pilgrim corridor resumes. Sikh girl abducted, forcibly converted to Islam in Pakistan. And locals highlight corruption in developmental works in Gilgit-Baltistan. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Ayurvedic practitioner Vaidya Harish Verma se apni sehat ko theek rakhne ya kisi bhi purani bimari ya rog ke bare salah le 416-804-1500 416-804-1500 2250 Buvet Drive East Unit 601 Brampton
आयुर्वेद दुनिया का सबसे प्राचीन मेडिकल सिस्टम है घुटनों का दर्द यानी आर्थराइटिस डायबिटीज कोलाइटिस या फिर त्वचा के रोग जैसे सफेद दाग यानी वटिलेगो सोराइसिस एक्जिमा आदि का आयुर्वेद में कैसे होता है इलाज देखें कनाडा के जाने माने आयुर्वेदिक प्रैक्टिशनर वैद्य हरीश वर्मा के साथ हेल्थ जरूरी है
वैद्य हरीश वर्मा के शो हेल्थ जरूरी है को टीवी चैनलों और यूट्यूब पर देखें और उनसे राब्ता करें 416-804-1500 416-804-1500 Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.